caught behind Venetian blinds, out to reach for the city lights. This ain't where I belong. Hey, look at me, mama, what I become.
This is a story about my phone and where it lives. In the Vermont mountains, by a lake, in a house, in a mudroom, on a hook, in a satchel, you will find my phone. There's not much else to know, to be honest. Nothing to see here, really, because this phone is off 90% of the time. I would say it gets turned on about once a week. Well, this is a boring story you might be thinking about now, but what if I told you that the owner of this phone has a career, runs her own business, multiple businesses actually, and still enjoys a growing, thriving community around her work? I guess you might start naturally thinking, well, how in the world can you run a business these days without a phone? I mean, don't you need a phone this day and age in order to be able to sell your work online or create a thriving community? You've got to be on top of this stuff, Kate. To which I will answer, yes. And no. See, this is a true story about where my phone lives and how I live largely without it. Not just in my personal life, but also in my business and career life. It stays in what I call my go bag, which is what I carry with me whenever I go out, because I do think it's a good safety measure to have a way to get in touch with someone. But other than that, it stays in that bag, turned off, nice and quiet, offering me zero interruptions or distractions. If you're thinking, how the... You're not alone. And that's the reason I'm actually making this video. Over the past year and a half of practicing living without a mobile phone, lots of people have asked me how I do this and still have a career, and perhaps more importantly, whether a lifestyle like mine is attainable to anyone else who might be interested. So here's my explanation. I'm sure I don't need to explain to you that many cultures these days seem to revolve around social media and devices and the images we create of ourselves online. While I do believe that this culture around social media and the internet can be quite toxic when we prioritize it, I'm not going to delve into that aspect too much here, because this video might end up an hour long. The short story is, there's ample and abundant research out there about how social media addiction is real and actually contributing to serious conditions like depression and anxiety. I honestly think that's one of the big reasons why a lot of us are becoming more interested in things like digital minimalism, mindful living, and minimalistic lifestyles in general. We can sense this stuff in our gut. We know. I believe our body's innate wisdom sends us warning signals. Over the past year and a half, I've been doing a lot of thinking and soul searching and research on this topic, and I feel like I've finally found rest in this answer. Phones and social media and the internet are not good. And they are not bad either. In fact, they are completely neutral things. Things. And like anything, they can be used mindfully or abused. There is nothing good or bad about them. They are completely neutral. They do not have thoughts or personalities or ideas. They are things. This realization is a simple one, but I found it liberating because it helped me to realize that the question I needed to ask myself was, how was I engaging this tool? How could I mindfully communicate with my audience without allowing social media to invade my life? I think the answer for everyone will be different, and it should be, but this was the path I personally decided to take. I turned off my phone and began to use it only when I needed to, mostly just when I left the house. I have a landline, and if I need to talk to someone, that's what I use, or I send them a message through my laptop. To update my social media pages, I go directly to those pages on my laptop and update them. I don't scroll through feeds, mindlessly consuming what massive corporations have decided to serve me. I go to my page, I post, I leave. Simple. And for most of these, I use a third-party app called Planoly that I've mentioned before in previous videos. I like their website because it's very minimal and visually calming. I use this to post on my Facebook and Instagram pages. And there are also other scheduling platforms out there a lot like it too, so find what you like. And that brings me to another point. You don't have to be on all these platforms. Pick the ones that you enjoy and that suit your vibe. Don't exhaust your mind trying to be everywhere. You do you, and your people will find you. The other key to this that I've come to see is very important is to simply be mindful about how you're using the internet. Ask yourself why often. Why am I here? Why am I watching? Why am I posting? And just allow yourself to honestly answer those questions without guilt or judgment. I try to plan when I'm going to post on my pages, and I stick to that time. I don't allow it to bleed over into my creative time. Give it a loving space. Give sharing time a home in your schedule and let it live there. Let it be a fun thing for you instead of a toxic, overwhelming, or impulsive experience. I've honestly had so much more fun with things like social media now that I've created a loving space for it, given it a healthy place to live in my schedule. So that's how I eliminated using my phone on any kind of regular basis. The phone is a phone, used for the odd phone call now and again, or to play a mindfully curated playlist in my car instead of the radio, and that's about it. Now, if you don't have a landline, I completely understand that while you may want to turn off your phone for good, you might not be able to, and that's okay. It's fine. There's no sacred rule to how this works, and there are plenty of ways to limit your phone usage. Get creative and explore for yourself. This is a journey. The most important underlying message behind all of this is an invitation to value yourself and your time in better and more mindful ways. When an object, a tiny object like a phone, sucks away our day, we aren't valuing our purpose, are we? And we all have so much purpose. So I hope this video has brought a little more clarity to how I practice this lifestyle. If it's nothing more than a simple springboard for how you can create your own unique practice for your own unique journey, well, I'd be thrilled. If you enjoyed this video, it always means the world when you take the time to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, because I would love to have you here in the community. I wish you joy in your journey, my friend. Thank you for being here.